Unicorns, dragons, minotaurs, all of these are great examples of magical creatures, but how can you create your own creatures? Welcome to Next Level Writing, and here are my top 10 tips for creating magical creatures for your writing. Before we begin, remember to like, subscribe, and share this channel. A shout out to Celeste, Olivia, and Zoe for requesting this video. In the comment section, feel free to leave video requests or a description of your newly created creatures. Now, look out, it's creature creating time. Number 10, genre. Before even getting to the details of a creature, an author must know and understand the genre and subgenre of their writing. This decision immediately gets the author to consider what role the creature will play. For example, if writing a fantasy story, the creature could be helpful or harmful to the main character. But in a horror, it is more than likely the creature will be dangerous and menacing. Number 9. Purpose. Once a genre is selected, an author can think about the purpose of the creature. Why does it exist? Is it helpful, a challenge to overcome, or is it the main antagonist of the story? Once the purpose of the creature is decided on, an author can begin to place the creature in the story. Does the creature need to be introduced early, or is it going to be the big reveal towards the end of the story? Number 8. Drawing. After the genre and purpose have been decided on, it is an excellent time to begin drawing the creature. While drawing, have in the back of your mind that this is not the final creature, and that the creature will most likely change as you continue through the next 7 steps. Number 7. Inspiration. The Earth is an amazing place with many different species of incredible animals. Often, the best imaginary creatures have been inspired by real-life animals. When thinking about which animal to look to for inspiration, think about where your imaginative creature would live. For example, if you are thinking about creating a creature that lives in the snow, start researching about animals that live in the snow and look for features they have in common, like the color of their fur or their size. Number 6. Special ability. At this point, you should have a rough idea about what your creature will look like. Now, you need to think about what special ability or abilities your creature will have. Will they be able to fly, shapeshift, shoot fire, control minds? The best creatures are the ones with unique and interesting abilities. Number 5. Defining feature. Building from the special ability, we now need to think about what defining feature your creature will have. By defining feature, I mean the thing that makes your creature stand out. Let's look at a hydra. A hydra takes inspiration from a snake. Its special ability is that it regenerates multiple heads if one of its heads gets cut off. For this reason, the defining feature of a hydra is its head. In fact, when writing about a hydra, the rest of the hydra's body is rarely mentioned. Number 4. Motivation. With the appearance of your creature well and truly underway, it is important to dig a little deeper and think about the internal workings of the creature. One place to start is the creature's motivation. What does it want? Does your creature like to be left alone? Is it protecting something like a treasure? Is it an obedient servant to an even more monstrous master? By knowing what motivates a creature, an author is able to predict how the creature will react in situations. Number 3. Personality. Flowing on from motivation is personality. The best creatures have distinct personalities. This is because a personality brings something to life. If you have a creature that is calm and gentle, it will act differently to a creature that is always angry and violent. To make this easier, think of the creature as another character, not just an animal. Number 2. History. The second last tip for creature creation is history. The history of your creature will impact how they interact with the world. Questions like, how long have they existed? What events have they been a part of? Are they common or are they extremely rare? Help to bring the creature to life. Thinking about the history of a creature can also allow an author to think about how the creature will fulfill their purpose, which was decided much earlier on in this video. Number 1. Name. Naming a creature can be tricky. A great place to start is to take your inspiration animal and translate it into a different language and add letters. For example, horse can be translated to cheval. Add some other letters and you can create names like chevalot or chevalox. When naming your creature, you also need to consider whether you are naming the individual animal or the species. An example of this is Medusa. Medusa is a monster with snakes instead of hair. It is said that one look at Medusa will petrify you, which means turn you to stone. Medusa was a gorgon, so the creature's name was Medusa, but the creature's species was gorgon. And there you have it, my top 10 tips for creating a creature. Remember to like and subscribe and share your new creatures in the comment section below. And as always, make sure to keep taking your writing to the next level. Thank you.